Thank you for this privilege, and I salute. welcome to my brother and my friend, Reverend Prophet Francis. Amen. Can we celebrate him? A great man of God. Hallelujah. And all the pastors, all the leaders here, I salute you. I bring you greetings from Tanzania, the family and the church. And I know that the Spirit of God is in this church. You see, in this end time, there are a lot of counterfeits in the system. So that is why you have to be committed to a profound church. And I believe that Church of God is one of the profound church. Hallelujah. Amen, amen. How do you feel here in the morning? Yeah, in the morning, I said it was introduction. So we'll take it up tonight and tomorrow morning and onwards. Don't miss it. Hallelujah. Wow. Within the next 1.5 hours, God is going to do something great. Lift up your hands wherever you are. Lift up your hands, Father, thank you.
Holy.
I will lift up my eyes unto the
hills, from whence cometh my help. My help cometh from the Lord that made the heavens and the earth. So as a child of God, whatever you receive shall be divine, meaning it will come from God. Repositioning means, from the Christian perspective, as I told you this morning and afternoon, it means when something changes in a different position, when something is being adjusted. So the basic word in this conference is that God is going to cause a change. God is going to cause a turnaround. God is going to cause a transformation. Another word that qualifies the word repositioning is total transformation. I decree by the word of God that after this week, your life will not remain the same. There shall be a total transformation in your life. Somebody shout yes. Hallelujah. Now I gave you one of the definitions for divine God, reposition, change, and turnaround. Now this morning afternoon, I gave you one definition of divine repositioning, and it means a supernatural. What is supernatural? Supernatural derived from two ways: superior plus natural. Super, something that is higher, above, something that is extraordinary. Supernatural, something that super exceeds the ordinary. The word supernatural comes from the Latin word supernaturalis. Supernatural is something that superimposes, something that prevails the ordinary. Now, when the supernatural comes in contact with the ordinary, the ordinary has no choice than to succumb, to give way for the supernatural. Ah, ladies and gentlemen, you may be ordinary, but in this supernatural, this year manifestation, the ordinary state of your life is a succumb, is a give way for the supernatural to prevail over your life. Somebody say, power. I declare over your life on this altar of grace, supernatural is hitting you now. Come on, let me hear you, baby. I said something that is above is coming upon you. Something that is above is falling your life, falling upon your ministry, falling upon your life. Somebody shout yes. Yes. Hallelujah. When the supernatural comes in contact with the ordinary has no choice than to give way for the supernatural to prevail. Shout hallelujah. Of divine or supernatural repositioning. Divine repositioning can also be known as experiencing the next level. Anytime there is a change, it means next level has taken place in your life. Change precedes next level. Change brings you to a higher ground and a higher rank. So, divine repositioning is also the next level experience. Somebody shout next level. Meanwhile, don't forget, divine is connected to grace. Supernatural connotes grace. So, grace is supernatural. Divine is supernatural. Somebody shout hallelujah. So today, tomorrow, I'll be sharing with you grace for the next level. Somebody say next level.
Next level.
Don't forget, I said, when change appears, next level experience also appears. Radical change. Reposition brings about what? Next level. Somebody say, I'm going to my next level. Oh, slap. Somebody say, I'm going to my next level. Oh, I cannot hear you. Come on, say, slap. Somebody say, you are going to the next level. Slap. Somebody say, you are going to the next level. Come on, slap someone and say, you can't remain where you are. Say, you are going to your next level by the supernatural, by grace. Shout yes. Hallelujah. I feel the power of God in the house. Amen, amen. But that's all to the word of God. Amen. Now, you have got to know, life is full of seasons and times. There are times and there are seasons. What is the season? A season is not time. Season is the kairos. Season is the appointed and the right time. There are times and there are appropriate times. Season is the right time of God. Season. My season has come. My season of reposition, meaning my proper time. There are times and there are proper times. I came to announce to you by the mantle of power, your right time and your proper time has come. Hey, come on. God has been doing some things in your life, but I declare this week and this season is your appropriate and your right time. Your right time to get money. Your right time to prosper. Let me hear it in touch of power. Your right time to the lifting. Your right time for the open door. Your right time to finish that project. Your right time for the church to go forward. Your right time to be healed. Your right time to be delivered. Somebody say, this is my right time. Shout yes. So there are times and there are seasons. And when season is born, it's the right time. We call it the harvest time. Amen. Come on, can I talk to somebody here? And in your right time, every opposition against your next level and reposition shall be overruled, shall be terminated. When your proper time is not to you, it seems as if and looks as if the enemies are prevailing. But when the proper time is to you, every opposition has no choice than to famous disappear. I came all the way from Tanzania with the mantle of power to announce unto you, any power resisting your destiny, the right time has come for them to lose you. Can I talk to somebody here? Come on, we can enjoy it for the night. So I come in the morning. We don't serve the dead God. We serve the living God. He's the same yesterday, today, and forever. If God be for you, who can be against you? Power is on your side. The Holy Ghost is on your side. Tonight I see by the supernatural, you are released to understand. You are released to go forward. You are released to prosper. You are released to testify. You are released. Somebody say release. Somebody say release. Somebody say yes. Has no choice. Shagadadadada. So I say, ay. And those at the back, I can hear you. I say, when your right time is due, say, every papa no suma. What stopped you before can stop you no more. What block your marriage can block you no more. Am I talking to somebody here? And I came to announce unto you, this is the season. It's a season of supernatural. It's a season of power. It's a season of grace. Somebody shout, yes! I'm talking to somebody here. Shout hallelujah. Ecclesiastes 3, please be seated. Amen.
Amen.
I've not started yet. It's just introduction. In Ecclesiastes chapter 3, now, the Bible says, there is time to sow, the time to what? The time to reap, time to harvest, time to cry, and the time to rejoice, time to mourn, and to dance, and to live. Life is full of season, and life is full of time. Now, you have to understand also, there is also a season of repositioning. There is a season, now, divine repositioning can also be termed as divine shift. Paradigm shift. Ayanda Kanda, somebody say yes, Lord. Divine repositioning is also known as war. A supernatural shift. Can I prophesy? There are 21 people that prophesy. God is shifting your life, shifting your ministry, shifting your finances. Come on, come and prophesy. I stand on this altar in the name of Jesus, and I prophesy to 21 people over here. I hear the Lord saying, there is a shift coming in your life, shift coming in your ministry,
an object cannot remain in position forever. Definitely there has to be a change. Have you seen this puppet? Has this puppet been here for 20 years or whatever? There comes a time the bishop will like this puppet to be shipped. Sometimes the bishop will like the will take the position of one of the puppet. That is how life is. Life, conditions of life are not always the same. Come on, there are times God creates a shift in your life. You have gone through enough. You have gone through pain. You have gone through disaster. But hear me, there is a season. Come on, here tonight. There is always a season. You tear tears, dust, and clothes. No job, no man or husband to call you sugar pie or honey. But I came to announce unto you, there is a season of turn and run and a shake. May the Lord remember you this season. May the Lord remember you in this conference. And may God cause a supernatural shake. Yeah, your life. Somebody shout hallelujah.
Is there anywhere here, God will free grow? Anyone here, you have a relative or you are connected from that place. Anyone here, Kahou Shata, Suka Pera Tuse Filia Nakudazia, Varia Nukuse Matuka Yasa, Bando Homa Kabde Suma, Talishata, Sumeta Haya, Kula Haya. Someone say power. Because of some ministry. Oh, but I'm preaching, I'm enjoying the preacher, I don't have to prophesy. But you see, the cancer, you don't have to do it. So, pardon? In the afternoon, okay. Now, somebody of your town, yes, you stay there, who stays there? You see, that I saw a satanic roadblock over there, a satanic roadblock. And the satanic roadblock, I see blood over there. But there's going to be a shift. Everybody who blood a satanic roadblock against everyone here on the road, there is going to be a shift. Somebody said, yes! The satanic bring. Somebody said, talk to me, man of God. Somebody said, man of God, talk to me. Somebody said, man of God, talk to me. In Exodus, the chapter 3, let's go to the word of God. Exodus, the chapter 3, the verse 7 and 8. Now, look at what happened. There was a very bush experience, supernatural encounter. Moses was born as a deliverer. God's people have been in captivity more than it was 400 years, but it exceeded to 430 years. God's children, they were still there. They need a deliverer. Tonight, I came with a mantle this week of deliverance, all the way from Tanzania. Any Pharaoh, any situation, the enemy has kept you in for long. By the mantle of deliverance, you shall come out. May the Mosaic mantle fall on you. May the Mosaic mantle, which is the mantle of deliverance, fall upon your life. That you will come out from every bondage. Somebody shout, I'm coming out. So the Bible says, God rest Moses with the mantle of deliverance. And look at what happened. He said, I the Lord. The Lord said, I have seen the affliction of my people. I have heard their cry. By the reason of their testimony, for I know their sorrows. Go down. Now, this is the word of God. Look at it. And I am come down to deliver them out of the hand of the Egyptians and to bring them out. Underline that word. I'm interested in that phrase. And to bring them up. If the Bible is yours, underline the word up. They were in bondage. They were in a level that they're supposed not to be. They were in a case that was satanic. Though there was a prophecy, but Pharaoh has hijacked their destiny more than the years expected. They were on the floor. Come, anytime you are on the floor, hear me. As a child of God, you are born again to come up from the floor. When you were in the world, you were on the ground, you were on the floor. Be born again, cost you for you to be lifted from the ground level to the up level. Can you hear me? When you were not born again, you were on the floor, you were on the ground. Be born again, cost you. But being born again brought a transition from the flood level to the up level. So the children of God were in Egypt, the hands of Pharaoh. When the season came, all these years, Pharaoh has been molesting them. There are some of you, your enemies, the family enemies, they have been molesting you. The demons, the enemies in the family, they've been sitting on your glory, your joy, your marital joy, your financial thing. But hear me, I told you, there is always a season. You cannot, as a child of God, you cannot be on the floor forever. Come on, you really hear me? If no child of God cannot be on the ground forever. When the season came, the supernatural appeared and says, I am bringing you up. The up from the Hebrew, Allah. Allah means to rise, to ascend, to grow. You have been in the realm of smallness. This is not your level. I have come down to reposition you from the level of smallness to the level of Yahweh Shaddai. In the name of Jesus, I prophesy to 15 people over here, wherever the enemy has kept you down, by the word of the Lord, you are coming up tonight. It's like those at the back, you are not in the service. I said, wherever the enemy has kept you down, by the word of God tonight, you are coming up. You will not remain on the floor. You will not remain in the hands of your enemies. Come, any Pharaoh in your life tonight is releasing you to go. Because the season of repositioning has come. In the season of repositioning, no Pharaoh can stop you. Oh, in the name of Jesus, I command you to come out. Come out of your situation. Come out of your mess. Come out of your disappointment. Come out of your disease. Come out of your bondage.
Grow. May your career grow. May your
the name of Jesus. I am not ordained to be small.
I am ordained to grow.
Do you know why? Man of God. You see, God said there are many nations, but the children of Israel, they are precious in my sight. They are mightier. Huh? They are what? They are mightier. Have you forgotten? The Bible says in Exodus chapter 1, the new king, the son of Pharaoh, and he said, let us deal with them wisely, because they are what? They are mightier than us. The destiny of God's children is to Makusha Kata. Who told you that you are small in the realm of the spirit? You are a giant. You are called Shabbat. I said in the spirit, you are a giant. Can I prophesy? I said fire in the house. I said in your family, you are the giant. You are the giant in your family. You didn't hear me. You are the giant in your family. You are not small. You are mightier. You are ordained by God to grow, to exploit. For the people that do not yet grow, they shall be strong, and they shall do exploit. They shall do greater things. They shall do mighty things. When this day came, I prophesy by the supernatural. Growth is coming. Shall it?
Come on. It is very important for you to contact the supernatural. Listen, divine supernatural repositioning. Amen. The only way God's children, their life can be turned around, it is only when God Himself comes down. Somebody say, come down. Say, oh Lord. Say, oh God. This week, come down. In my life, shall we say, oh God. Say, you are here. You were yesterday. Sunny. Oh, my bravo. This week, I feel it. Oh God. Come down. With your power. With your glory. With your fire. Boom, several more places here.
The earth was to be fertile.
The earth was to be productive. The earth was to bring forth. But the Bible says initially, the earth was without form and void. It was shapeless, meaning it was in a state of emptiness and nothingness. Nothing was working on the earth. But the real purpose of God for creating the earth was what? For the earth to bring fruit, to grow, to produce, to bring harvest. But nothing was happening in the beginning. There are many things. The purpose of created you, listen to you, in him was life, and life was the light of men. You are born again to manifest the light and the glory of God. The Zoe, the light, the embodiment of Jesus is in you. So as a child of God, you are born again to manifest the glory of God. Romans 8, verse 19. For the earnest expectation of the creature waiting for the manifestation of the sons of God. So you are born again so that you will actualize the purpose and the will, the destiny of God for your life. But what do we see now in your life as a child of God? Nothing is working. Your life, some of you can be likened to the earth. You see, the earth, nothing was working. Emptiness, it was bare, no result. The earth was producing no result. The earth was empty. The earth was in a zero point. Nothing was working. There are many of you last year or previous years, things have not been working. No result, no productivity, no blessing, no joy. No partner in your life, no favor from anywhere. But ladies and gentlemen, God is about to reposition your life this year. Shout hallelujah. Now look at what happened here. So the Bible says, Kahadeo Shoko Alasatamaya. Oh, Shadaham Hosataya. Say the Lord, Kao Shata, the Leko Sukataya. Madam, stand up. Do you have any baby girl? A baby girl, right? I see the glory of God upon that baby girl. Sing it alone. That baby girl will move far. God has given that baby girl wisdom. That's why, as the baby girl was growing, she speaks beyond her age. She speaks, she don't speak. God said that that girl will go very far. She'll bring glory to you. She's a treasure to you. Clap for Jesus here. Oh, can you clap for Jesus over here? So the Bible says the earth was without form and void, nothing was working. Now look at here. And darkness was upon the face of the deep. What is darkness? Generally, darkness promotes favor. Darkness represents suffering. Darkness means there was a covering. There was a covering on the earth. Darkness means chaos. Nothing was working. And the Bible said, and God said, before God said, the Holy Ghost moved first. The Spirit of God is the strength of God. Meaning, before God could perfect and fulfill his purpose on earth, the Spirit of God has to move the strength of God. For it is not by might, neither by power, but the Spirit of God. Hear me. There are many of you that need to fulfill God's purpose, one way or the other. There is a covenant with your life. There is a covenant with your glory, your destiny. But tonight, by the word of God, every covenant is being removed from your life. Yeah. Isaiah 25, verse 7. Upon this mountain shall the Lord cast away the veil and the covering upon his people. Every covering of your destiny, I declare the word of God, let that covering be removed now. Every covering on your wedding, marital destiny, let that covering. The Spirit of God has to take over first. And the Bible says, and God said, let there be light. Don't forget, the earth was in the state of what? Nothingness. There are some of you who are in a level, in a position that you're supposed not to be. You are not really manifesting the level that God wants you to be. The earth was at its zero point. Don't forget, the earth was at its what? Zero point.
nothing was working. But the purpose of God for the earth was what? Was to produce and to be productive. You are born again to bring results. You see, ye are the light of the world. Hallelujah. Ye are the light of what? Of the world. Let your light shine. You are born again to manifest the light, the glory of God. Whatever that has stopped or hindered, frustrating your manifestation, you will receive power to manifest. Let me hear you again and about it. Whatever that has been blocking and frustrating your manifestation, you will receive the supernatural to manifest. Somebody shout hallelujah.
Let's go to the word of God. Let us work out. So the Bible says the Holy Ghost moved. The Holy Ghost was hovering upon the waters. Now God, that gave God, got the momentum and he declared, let there be what? Let there be light. Now what is light? Light means, from the Hebrew, or it means life. It means salvation. Now look at me. Number one, why did God speak on the earth? Because the earth has to take its actual level. So God has to speak. Now as a child of God, as the Spirit of God moves upon the face of the waters, so you are a carrier of the Spirit of God. The Holy Ghost is in you. You are anointed by God to speak into your situation for the lesson. The Spirit of God moves upon the face of the water. As a child of God, you are a container of the Holy Ghost. As a born again believer, you are what? You are a container of the Holy Ghost. You are a carrier of the Spirit of God. The Holy God gave you the Holy Spirit. God gave you the Spirit so that you be able to declare on your situation that is unbearable for you to be loose to your next level. So God has to speak, declare, prophesy on the earth that let it be light, meaning light means life. Let it be light on earth. The second reason why God spoke unto the earth, let it be light, meaning all earth be repositioned, all earth receive a change, all earth you must be turned around in the name of Jesus by the Spirit of God in you. This season, this week, you got to speak into your next level. You got to speak into your glory. Am I talking to somebody here? Out of the mouth of the beast and suffering, has the Lord of their strength. God has anointed your tongue. He has anointed your mouth to speak into your situation. This year by the supernatural, I will have my wedding. This year by the supernatural, I will begin the ministry. This year by the supernatural, we will have two or three services. This year by the supernatural, I will finish my project. I will graduate from the university. As God spoke for repositioning on the earth, God sent me to tell you, wherever you are, you have to speak the word of God. So my word that goeth out of my mouth, it shall not return unto me void, but it shall accomplish the purpose for which it was sent. For by two immutable things, it was impossible for God to lie. Let every man be a liar, but let God be the true God. Once the Lord has spoken, and twice have we heard, the power belongeth unto our God. I came from Tanzania to announce unto you, there is power inside you. You have to speak into your situation. I will not remain where I am. I will not be poor. I shall not be sick. Speak for your next level. Speak for your life to be repositioned. Your destiny is in your mouth. Your manifestation of your destiny is like the words you declare from your mouth. I prophesy, and God said, let it be light. Tonight, how many of you, you are ready to speak to your next level? You are ready to speak for your next level. You are ready to speak for your life to change. How many of you, you are ready to say, we shall come. God is saying, you gotta speak it. Speak a change. Speak a lifting. Speak a next level of your life. Somebody shall speak. Somebody
shall be
free.
Clap for Jesus.
Hallelujah. Somebody shout
hallelujah.
And God said, let it be war. Talk to me. And God said, let it be war. Let it be war. Why did God have to speak on the earth? Because the earth has not taken its what? Its actual and divine position. Therefore, the essence of God prophesying on the earth is for the earth to what? Oh, talk to me, Christians. It's for the earth to what? It's for that the earth to reposition and take its normal place. In the name of Jesus, I came by the power of God in my tummy, and I declare the word of God unto you, that if you release, have you forgotten, out of your belly shall flow rivers of the living water. There is power inside you. If you can speak into your situation, that this year my life will never be the same. Death and life there in the power of the tongue. I declare over your life that by the word of God, your life is changing. Your destiny is changing. God is repositioning your life. And the Bible said, and there was light, and there was life, and there was salvation, and there was a performance in this conference. If that would be a performance and a change in your life, you got to walk, you got to speak. Oh my God, somebody got to speak. Now listen to me. As a Christian, in life, if you are not speaking, your challenges will be talking. You mean, take it. Those who heard will clap. Listen to me. As a born-again believer, if you are not speaking, declaring the word of God, your challenges will be speaking to you. It's also here, I'm saying, here, we are here. 40 years, don't worry. Every university, in need man. But as a child of God, hey, yet though I walk through the valleys of the shadows of death, I will fear no evil, for thou with me, the rod and the staff, they come for me. I don't have a job, but I have to get a job. I am sick, but I am healed. I am down, but I shall be lifted. If you are not talking, your enemies will be speaking, and the issues of life, they will be detected to you. Yes, that is what you have to talk. God has to speak upon the earth for the earth to take its what? To take its normal shape. Shout yes.
Yes. Yes.
Love for Jesus.
Yes. Yehovah, see I sing
Yeah.
grace for my next level.
Thank you.
just have your hands. We are still praying. Oh, Sakara, the angel of God from this altar, the angel of God from this altar is going to Tokyo to deliver that person. I see containers. I see containers. I see containers. Who is that? No, are you a member of this church? Are you a member of this church? Huh? Shaka Abba Nakata Ushabala.